Miami. This is a big event city, and folks here are fired up for this one inside Hard Rock Stadium as the Miami Hurricanes try to represent the great tradition of their program. And a rivalry like this is what makes college football great. Yeah, the tradition and the history, but right here, right now, there's great intensity. This is why these guys came to these schools to play in games like this. As we'll see the number 11 team in the country, the Florida State Seminoles, taking on the 23rd ranked team, the Miami Hurricanes. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, here in the booth with Kirk Herbstreit. I think we've talked long enough, Kirk. Let's get this game going. The Seminoles will kick this deep to start us off. And he takes this from inside the five. Makes it to the 16. That's good coverage there. The Hurricanes offense comes on the field to open this game. Here we go, Kirk. All the emotion in this stadium. Which side is going to handle that better today?
Chris, we had a chance to visit both these teams, and one of the things that we saw, the clock's ticking down all year for this game, this day. Now they get their chance.
Chris, this is what I'd love to see from a defense, is the linebackers are scraping, doing their job, but you need help from the secondary. And when you have aggressive tacklers on the back end, you got a great defense. This time, the secondary makes the difference.
They got some ground to make up, second and long from the 15. And now the running back's got it again. They'll tackle him out across the 20.
When you can get good chunks of yardage like this on early downs, it just keeps you on schedule, leading to more manageable third down situations. Never underestimate the value of consistently getting four more yards a pop like that.
On this opening possession, they'll face a third down and five. And they'll keep it on the ground. Running back has the handoff. Fighting for yardage, but the defense stops him just short of that first down marker. The Canes will send their punt team onto the field. Looking to flip the field here. He's got an opening. Watch out. He's got great speed. Returner tackle right there. That's where they'll start the drive. So Florida State's offense makes their way onto the field for their first possession. Well, it's not easy to narrow down the impact players to just a few guys, Kirk, but what do you expect from them today?
Well, we got guys that can make plays as well as anybody in the country on both sides of the ball. That's why I think this matchup is so exciting. Two good teams with great individual players.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Oh, he's looking to throw. He'll be wrapped up on the scramble there, settling for a short gain. And remember, the last time these teams met, it came right down to the wire.
Well, Chris, there's so many great rivalry games that we all look forward to every single year. But with these two teams, it just always seems to be a tight matchup.
The important third down play coming up. To throw, it's Uiagalelei. It's a short completion at the big tight end. Brought down at the 46, good enough for a first down.
This is what you love to see, right? Quarterback does a nice job of looking and finding his open receiver, and he waits to the last possible second. In fact, Chris, he gets hit as he gets that ball out of his hand. So good job of showing some strength and a good job of throwing with accuracy as he's taking that hit.
On first and 10 here, looking to throw the ball. The short completion of the tight end. And the defense swarms, not much of a gain on that completion.
And here the tight end shows off his hands for a nice game. Love to see the big man get his touches.
Pass complete. It's second down now. Takes the handoff. It's Williams. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. Well, that was that excellent linebacker with a clear path just running downhill quickly.
You know, I think one of the great things about watching this guy play all year is his vision. He just has great instincts. That time the defensive line ate up all the linemen, freed up the linebacker to get into the backfield, and the result is a tackle for a loss for the backer.
Play action fake, looking to throw. caught over the middle. It's Benson. They finally get him down, but an explosive play. The offense in business now at the 24.
And you just continue to see the chemistry between these two. And they told us yesterday in our production meeting, they spent hours and hours of working and developing that chemistry and that rhythm by throwing together throughout those summer months. And man, it's starting to really pay off. He's become his security blanket for the quarterback, and especially on third down, get him the ball.
Defense surrounds him, just a short gain on that completion.
Just a good job of spreading the wealth, making sure everybody's getting their touches. When you do that, the defense can't lock in on one guy or two guys. Make them have to be aware of everybody, and allows you to continue to spread the ball around and spread the field, making it tougher for this defense.
Dropping back to Uiagalelei. Catch made over the middle. Finally stopped at the four. Great catch and run.
Man, what a great effort by the tight end. Not only does he make the catch, but how about the effort there to break that tackle to pick up more yards?
The Noles trying to punch it in. It's first and goal. And the quarterback keeps it on the option. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
That's just exactly how you coach it from a defensive standpoint. You string the quarterback out to the outside, make him indecisive. By the time he makes a decision, the rest of the defense is coming in. Nice tackle for a loss.
Backed up to the 5-yard line now for second and goal. Kibbe decides to keep it here. Couldn't quite get there, brought down at the 2.
Good job by the offensive line. You get some positive yards, but not quite into the end zone. Now we're going to have a 3rd and goal.
We'll see what the offense dials up here on 3rd and goal. Getting set for the second quarter here. Both offenses searching for a spark. They didn't do much in the first quarter at all. Getting set here now for the second period. Both offenses looking for some efficiency, for a spark after that opening quarter. They try to muscle toward the end zone on the ground. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Florida State. Wow, that is an impressive start, Kirk. In an emotional game like this, to be so efficient, to click like that early, is impressive.
Well, it's very impressive and a great way to start for this team, because all the buildup and all the hype, now you can just settle in and play your game.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. And the PAT makes it 7-0 to open scoring. The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. And here's the return from inside the 5. And the returner will be brought down. And the Hurricanes offense retakes the field. They're coming off a 3-and-out, looking to produce a positive drive here. Looking for some space. It's Martinez. Oh, there's the stiff arm. They bring him down right at the 20.
Chris, the defense dials up the blitz. They're unable to get into the backfield, giving the running back enough room. I'll tell you, the linebacker makes a great play just to come up with a tackle here.
Now it's 2nd down here. One back in the backfield, and he'll get the carry. Brought down at the 33. That's good enough to move the sticks.
Good job up front by this offensive line, and good hard running. But as Miami Hurricane back, he's doing everything he can to live up to the long legacy that the Canes have at this running back position.
Big guys up front lined up. It's 1st down. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Quick completion to the tight end. And a nice 1st down gain there. They get him down, but very close to the 1st down marker.
Well, this is why running the football is so important. You run the ball and then you go play action. It affects the eyes of the safeties and linebackers and frees up some space for the tight end to be able to pick up a nice game.
The backfield is empty here for second and inches. Send the back in motion. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Tackled at the 44, but good enough for a first down.
A nice little simple touch pass here by the quarterback, getting the ball out to the receiver who's in motion. Look, that doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down. And no offense is ever going to say no to moving the chains.
The Hurricanes churn out another first down. But go with the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff. Throws a stiff arm. Heads out of bounds after a solid gain, more than enough to pick up a first down.
Boy, how about that play, Chris? That thing just opened up the back shot tool there with great acceleration. What a pickup there on first down.
And the Canes come to the line to start a fresh set of downs. Handoff running right. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
Chris, I think we all kind of get caught up in third down. What is an offense doing on third down? But I think what's also important is how well you defend first down. If you can hold your opponents to a short gain or a tackle for a loss, you throw the offense out of whack, and their game plan gets much more challenging to try to come up with that first down.
Defense gets him down, but they'll take the gain on that play.
I'll take that every single time. Offensive line does a nice job up front. This back's vision and ability to get positive yards by lowering his pads on full display right there.
Not going to be easy here. Backed up a long way to go for a first down. Looking to throw. It's Ward. The pocket breaking down. Just throws it away, but takes a big hit in the process.
Hey, it's an incompletion, but it's a nice job by the quarterback. I know it didn't pan out, but the most important thing is he didn't turn the football over and he didn't take a sack. It'll give your kicker a chance to put some points on the board if they opt for the field goal here on fourth down.
The decision is not to go for it on fourth down. Here comes the field goal team. And they will trust the kicker here from 55 yards out. Let's see if he can get it there. He missed it. Field goal, no good. And after the miss, still down by 7.
Boy, this guy's usually more reliable than this. I thought that was going to be an easy field goal and 3 points, but instead, he misses, so you walk away with nothing.
And the Florida State offense heads back onto the field. Great possession last time. They punch it into the end zone. Can the defense come up with a stop this time? The gain is 3. Now it's 2nd down and 7.
For the defense coordinator this week, all week telling us about gap integrity, not giving this running back any creases at all. Really sound defense on that play.
Offense getting set up. Here's 2nd down. One man at the backfield, and he'll get the football. He's wrapped up nicely there by the freshman. Well, Kirk, you played in rivalry games. No shortage of inspiration, but how do you manage the emotion of it all?
Well, I think you need great leadership from the team. Sometimes teams don't handle the emotions of it, and the game can get sideways on you. The teams that play the best in rivalry games are the teams that have the best leaders to keep them focused on the task at hand.
Quarterback in the shotgun here on 3rd down. Doesn't hold on. Good hit by the DB. Now it brings up 4th down.
Well, they go to the air to try to pick up this first down, but it just wasn't meant to be. Defense was ready, made sure to force them into this 4th down situation.
And the Seminoles bring their punt team onto the field. Bounce right at the 3-yard line and into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes the Miami offense back out onto the field. They need something out of this possession. The last time they settled for a field goal attempt, but then they missed it.
Well, this guy's got some wiggle, and you can see there he's got some power. He's able to break through one arm tackle, but the secondary comes up to finish him off.
That's the 2-minute warning in this close first half. The offense trying to score and claim the lead before the break. The offense goes 5 wide, empty backfield. to the air. It's Ward. He's running out of time here. It's incomplete. He was hit as he threw that time. And now third down coming up.
Man, you gotta love this if you're defensive coordinator. It's all about affecting the quarterback and getting pressure on him. This time they got to him and forced that incompletion.
After the incompletion, they'll have to try to convert here on third and nine. Looking for the wideout. Who makes the grab? Out of bounds, but not before a huge gain. Offense gets a fresh set of downs.
That is great arm strength and accuracy by this quarterback. Let's not forget the wide receiver's job of bringing it in for that big game.
This offense has gotten going at long last. It's another first and 10. And he'll set up to throw. Cannot escape that ferocious pass rush. It's a sack.
Man, that's how you respond after giving up such a big play through the air. The next play, you get after the quarterback, make some adjustments, and come up with a nice sack.
They'll crank up the tempo here with the clock ticking down. Second down. From the shotgun, he's probing the secondary. It's caught downfield. They make the stop, but not before a solid gain that time.
And there's the tight end who shows off his hands.
The Canes lining up here on first and 10. There's the snap. Quarterback setting up to throw. Quick catch over the middle. Breaks one tackle, gets brought down, but picks up some decent yardage.
Now the receiver does all the work here. Man, that is easy living for this quarterback. Really good footwork by the receiver, gets the separation, and at that point, it's just pitch and catch for the quarterback.
Getting set. Here's second down. Looking to throw. It's Ward. Short connection to the tight end here. Timeout is called to talk strategy late in this close game with halftime approaching. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? Drops back from the shotgun, looking for an open man. Caught on the outside. It's Joseph. And he heads out of bounds after gaining a few yards.
Well, here the defense decided to sit back and play zone, and that front didn't do a good job of pressuring the quarterback. He had the time to make the throw, and he put it on target.
The Hurricanes are going to cash in this red zone trip. Quarterback wants to throw it on second down. And he can't escape. It's a sack for the defense. And now the offense will call a timeout. Something the coach didn't like about this. Crucial play coming up. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Got to do something here on third down to get back in range. Dropping back. Looking to throw for the first down. And he scores. Touchdown, Miami.
Perfect timing here by this quarterback. Great read. Puts the ball where his man can make a play on it. And they're an extra point away from tying this game up.
Now they line up to kick the extra point. And it's up and good. So the offense getting some momentum before halftime with the touchdown. Now they kick off in hopes the defense can get a quick stop. Returner choosing to field this one. He'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. And the Seminoles offense comes back on the field. They were held to a quick three and out last time, looking to put together a positive drive here. Oh, the pass is picked off. He's got some room and some blockers here. Touchdown for the U. And the defense adds six from the interception return. And a pick six, a monster play by this defense here, Kirk.
That defender showed a lot of athletic ability there with the ball in his hands. I wouldn't be surprised if the head coach watching that thought about maybe giving him some reps as a returner after that touchdown.
And they'll set up with the PAT. He PAT makes it a 7-point lead. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. So after the touchdown, here's the kickoff, and we'll see if the opposing offense has time to answer before halftime. That one sails out of the back of the end zone at the touchback. So a little under 30 seconds to go in the half. We'll see how they play this here in first and 10. Looking out throwing here to start the drive. That's reeled in. It's Benson. To get him down quickly, not much of a gain on that completion.
Love the timing here between the quarterback and his receiver. Pick up some positive yards, and I continue to be impressed with just the chemistry between these two.
Looks like one more play here before halftime. To throw, it's Uiagalelei. Catch made on the right side. They make the tackle as time expires. That'll do it for the first half. And that will do it for the first half here. Kevin Connors now has our halftime update.
Guys, between the coaches who have matched wits in this game and the players and the unforgettable moments, Miami, Florida State is must-see TV, and today is no different. And it's been said football is a game of inches, and guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how this rivalry matchup plays out.
And here comes the Florida State offense on the field. First play of the drive, they come out throwing. Physical defending, that one falls incomplete, brings up second down.
Well, these guys just continue to struggle throwing the football. You know, whether it's been running the wrong route, the quarterback not being accurate, the offensive line not doing their job, it's been a collective effort, and it's a big reason why they're trailing now in this game.
Incompletion sets up a second down. Gives it to the back. Spinning out of the tackle. Tough running there. Breaks a tackle, picks up the first down.
Well, anytime you're down at halftime, you get your minds together, you try to make some adjustments, you try to get things heading in a better direction. This offense is off to a great start after this play right here.
And now from the pistol formation. On first down, they'll keep their running game churning. And that gain enough for a fresh set of downs, spotted at the 48.
Look, I realize on any play call, when it's properly executed, it can go to the house for a touchdown. But the runs that really make a game plan work are the ones where you get just what you need. And he barely got the first down, but he got it.
And the Noles will line up on first and 10. Gonna run it. It's Williams. The sophomore with a strong tackle there.
Chris, you know, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but what I've been always impressed with the defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
Empty backfield, offense spreading the field with five wide. Quick pass, here comes a jet sweep. Fights off a defender. And the defense grabs him after the completion. He's just short of a first down.
You know, the good thing about this play is it's not an explosive play, but it really gives you a chance now to be able to pick up a first down here on this next play.
Solid gain on the running play. Third down now. Quick throw caught on the left side. Tackle made at the 41. That's first down yardage.
This is a big conversion by this offense. They're down now in the second half. Probably limited opportunities at this point in the game. Every chance you get your hands on the ball, you need points. They keep this drive alive right here.
Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. Looking to pass. It's Uiagalelei. Quarterback looks to his right and finds his man. Refusing to be brought down before gaining first down yardage.
But good job with the offensive line giving his quarterback time to throw. And you can see the damage he can do to you when he does have time. A great throw and something you just kind of expect in Tallahassee. A quarterback that can make throws like this.
It's a first and 10 play coming up for the offense. Grab down the middle. It's Morlock. A huge hit by the linebacker. A collision of big bodies there. The Seminoles are in the red zone. They'll run it here. There's the tackle, but first down yardage.
Was a nice job up front by the offensive line, but give the running back an assist for setting those blocks up before he's able to get downfield for the first down.
First down and 10 now. Caught in the backfield. It's Benson. The defense all over it. They stop him right at the line.
Boy, they're just fundamentally sound, right where you want to be after the completion. Nowhere to go after that catch.
Coming to the line on second down, this is important. They want to avoid a third and long. Trying to find room. It's Williams. Defense stops him, but that's a solid gain.
It's a good, solid gain. 5 or 6 yards. Love to see that from the running game.
Here we go, third down, close to the goal line. They can still get a first down without scoring. To throw, it's Uiagalelei. Makes the catch, can he get in? The defense stops him just short of the marker. That'll bring up fourth down.
Chris, great effort here by this defense to keep him short of the first down. Now they've got a tough decision to make here on this fourth down and short.
So the decision is to not go for it, but settle for three. Here comes the field goal team. So from the left hash, this is just a chip shot. And it's no good. He missed it. And after the miss, still down by 7.
Now that's going to go down as an empty possession for this offense. No points as he's off target. Now you can see he's hanging his head. A poor kicker.
And the Miami offense is back on the field. They were clicking last time. Great protection. The pitch and catch was solid. Right down for a touchdown. First play of the drive, looking to throw the football. Grab behind the line. It's Martinez. The defense drops him for a loss. They went backwards there. A second down behind the sticks now.
Boy, the defense does such a good job of taking any threat downfield away. All he could do is throw it to his back and loss of yards. Now you're behind the sticks.
Short loss on the play sets up second and long from the 18. Ball handed off. Going to try to run inside, but nowhere to go.
That was an excellent effort by this defense, just staying in their run fits, holding their own at the line of scrimmage, and then making a tackle. Offense just couldn't get enough of a push to get any yards at all.
Offense breaks the huddle and gets set. It's third down. Kirk, as we take a break for the quarter here, it's Miami in front. We've reached the end of three. Time is running out to cut into the lead. Let's take a look at the game stats before we move on. One quarter to go. Let's see if this sets up as a classic finish. Well, a serious challenge for this offense. You don't want to be in third and long inside your own 20. How much of a risk will they take to try to pick him? Pressured and dropped back at the 8-yard line.
Great call here going with that nickel defense, giving you more speed on the field on that third down and long. Nowhere to go. Gave the defensive line plenty of time to come up with that sack. And now it's fourth down and long.
The Canes will send the punt team onto the field. Looking to kick it away for the second time. And the ball is away from inside the 10. when he's got some space here. And the coverage seam gets the returner to the ground. And the Florida State offense heads back onto the field. Moving the receiver around pre-snap. A pop pass on the jet sweep. And the senior able to make the stop after a short gain.
Man, that jet sweep action puts so much pressure on a defense. You get so locked in on the ball attacking you downhill. But when offenses sprinkle this kind of offense in, it stretches this defense out wide and can create some vertical seams for big plays.
Second down after that run on the previous play. With the catch, it's Benson. And the gain just good enough for a first down.
I feel like this quarterback could make this throw in his sleep. It's like clockwork, a curl route against zone. And the quarterback, the only thing is he had to fit it into a tight window for that first down completion.
That completion good for a first down. The offense working with a new set of downs here. And now the handoff. They stop him after a 6-yard gain, so second and 4.
Great job by the offensive line here, opening up some holes and giving the running back room to run on first down. Plays like this can open up the playbook for the play caller, allow him to make that defense think, are they going to run? Maybe play action, maybe throw the ball downfield.
And the sophomores got him for a sack.
Chris, that is textbook by this defense in man-to-man coverage. Nowhere to go for this quarterback. He's looking around everywhere to find an open man. By the time he figures it out, it's a sack for the defense.
They're backed up here, trying to make something happen on third and long. From the shotgun, it's a handoff. And the broken tackle there produces a solid gain. Here we are late in a one-score game, and they're going to go for it on fourth down. Using his legs, it's Williams. And he picks up the first down before they get him to the ground.
That's just mano a mano right there. Offensive line does their job, gets a nice surge there, and the back does what he needs to do to pick up the first down.
The offense getting closer to a game-tying touchdown. It's first and 10. From inside the red zone, they're looking to throw. Fires it. He's got it, looking for the end zone. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Knowles.
Hey, this running back's going to show you he can be a receiver as well. He's just not back there running the football. Nice job of showing that versatility. Pulls it in and gets 6.
They're set now to try the PAT. And that PAT gives us a tie ball game here in the final quarter. Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away. They'll take the return and try to get some better field position. And the coverage team able to bring him down. And the Hurricanes offense retakes the field. They're coming off a quick 3-and-out, so looking to put something together on this drive with a little more urgency. Let's fly to the wideout. And it's complete downfield. He's tackled short of the 30, but that's good enough for a first down.
The defense spreads all over the field playing zone, trying to make this quarterback make a mistake by throwing it into coverage. But he finds the soft spot on the curl and picks up a first down.
Completion good for first down yardage for this offense. Dropping back, it's Ward. Snags the quick throw. They make the tackle, but that pass creates a solid gain.
Just a good job here by the quarterback. Got the ball out to his receiver. His guy eats up some yards. They stay ahead of the sticks.
Offense getting set. Second down play here. Shotgun formation. Here's an inside give. They get him down at the 41, but that's good enough for a first down.
Sometimes I almost get mesmerized watching these runners who have great vision. You know, the eyes that carry their feet to the open space, making people miss. I just love watching those guys do work.
Match the 2-minute warning as the clock stops. Give both coaches a chance to strategize here before the time runs out. The Hurricanes will have first and 10 here. Here's the snap. Offense looking to throw the ball. Caught over the middle. It's Restrepo. Explosive gain across midfield. They'll spot it about the 35.
Chris, this guy has a big-time arm. He just zipped the ball in there. You know, you can sometimes show your arm strength in other ways than just bombing it deep.
Big chunk play. This offense operating at peak efficiency. Handoff to the back. He stopped just short of that first down marker, inches away from it.
Love those positive yards on first and 10, and it's quite a first down. Looks like it'll bring second and inches, but it sure does open up the playbook here to be able to open up, maybe take a shot downfield.
Second down after that run on the previous play. He'll ride the back again here. He's brought down, but not before he gets first down yardage. Timeout called by the defense, their first of the half, as they try to make some adjustments here.
And that's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. Don't forget, good blocking up front by the big fellas. And this running back, he just seems to have a nose for that first down marker. A few more runs like this, and he's going to be getting into it.
He's got some room. Can he get there? Force out of bounds, but a nice gain there, and the offense will have a first and goal.
Nothing better than an offense on first down to be able to pick up big positive yards like that. You can either keep giving it to the back, or it can set up play action and get the defense to come up to the line of scrimmage, and you can throw it over top of it.
First and goal, handoff. And he muscled out of bounds, very close to the goal line.
Positive yards at this point in the game are always important, especially now that you're starting to get well within the range of a field goal to take the lead. But if I'm this offensive coordinator and quarterback, I'm thinking about a touchdown here late in the game.
Second down and goal. On the ground, trying to power toward the goal line. Touchdown, Canes. They jump in front here in the fourth.
Chris, I thought we might be headed to overtime here, but this offense would not be denied. Outstanding execution, and they take the lead. Now it's all about can their defense hold on to see if they can get this win.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. PAT is up and good. They lead by a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. So after the late score, they'll kick it off and hope the defense can hold up, preserve this lead. Fields it inside the 5-yard line. And the returner is brought down. And the Seminoles offense comes back on the field. So here we go. It could come down to this possession, Kirk. Sets up as a potential classic finish.
Well, Chris, after everything that's gone on in this field in a rivalry game, if you're a quarterback, this is what you dream about. Having the ball in your hands with a chance to lead your team down and potentially win this game.
They need to score quickly here, trying to dial up some big plays. And looking to throw now on first down. That's caught. It's Douglas. They stopped the receiver, but that's a solid gain on that play.
Man, give the defense a lot of credit. You're taking away the elite receiver. That primary target forces the quarterback to find a second or third option. He gets positive yards, but anytime you can take away the big play late in the game, it's going to help you be able to secure victory.
And the offense wisely spikes the ball here to stop the clock. Offense needs points quickly here, trying to dial up some explosive plays. Let's see what they've got called. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. Makes the catch downfield. And the offense will spend a timeout, stopping the clock with 22 seconds remaining. This could be a dramatic finish, marching toward a tying touchdown. It's first and 10. Scanning the field, it's Uiagalelei. Running out of time in the pocket. Couldn't find anybody open and just has to throw it away. So, second down after the incompletion. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. Pressure is coming. And the sophomore making an impact play.